I am Stu Leonard, and welcome to Stu Leonard's Wines. Guess where I'm standing right now? I'm not with a bunch of turkeys. I'm not out at a cattle ranch in Montana. I'm not with a bunch of lobsters up in Maine. I'm standing in the middle of Stu Leonard's Wines with 100,000 bottles of wine and our vice president of wines right here, Jerry Martellaro, a good friend of mine. And you know what? We're going to talk about champagne. We have this booklet right here, which is answers to what you ask us every year. You know what one of the biggest ones is? What kind of champagne do I buy? And what's the difference between champagne and sparkling wine? Well, guess what? We have the guy that's going to answer all these questions for us. Jerry's the expert. He has 400 books on wine at his house. He's told me he's read every one of them. So Jerry, we picked four sparkling and champagnes right here. Why don't you walk us through them and tell us what the difference is?
All right, the first one is a true French champagne. So let's take the part of the misnomer. What is champagne and what is sparkling? Technically, if anything cannot be called champagne unless it comes from the area of Champagne, whether it be Reims, Epernay, Eye. So anything outside those areas cannot be called champagne. Yes, some you'll find some generic names like Andre and stuff that say champagne, but technically, by the strict letter of the law, anything that comes from the area of Champagne can be called champagne. This first true champagne is from Heidsieck Monopole. It comes from Epernay, which is pretty much the Grand Cru of champagne areas. True French champagne has got Chardonnay, a little Pinot Noir, a little Pinot Meunier. It's a 200-year-old firm, quality champagne that sells for under 25 bucks a bottle. You'd be hard pressed to find better quality in this bubbly.
Now, when somebody says Brut, what does that mean?
Brut is a degree of dryness. It's when they ferment it, they ferment it dry. There's a misnomer, Brut and extra dry. To clarify it, extra dry is less dry than Brut. So Brut is dry, it goes in degrees of sweetness. It goes extra dry, Brut, then it goes Blanc de Blanc.
But if you were gonna sell 100 bottles of champagne, how much would you 90, sell?
95 of them, 95, 90 to 95 of them would be Brut.
Okay, so most people buy Brut.
Right, because okay. It has just an odor of fruitiness in it and just a kiss, a little bit of sugar on the finish.
And you know what's nice? You don't have to drink champagne just for a celebration.
No, champagne is really, it's not a celebratory wine. It's been misplayed as a celebratory wine, but you could drink champagne all year round. Yeah. You can have it with meals, as an aperitif. You know what? It's something when you come home. We have some friends in the wine business, the Domenighettis, and you know they sell some of the finest wines in the world. And what they do when they go home at night after a long day in their office, they open up a bottle of champagne just to enjoy that they've gotten home and they've had a good day. Yeah. The next one is Nicolas Francois Brut. This is just a sparkling wine from the south of France, made with a little bit of Chenin Blanc. You know, people are always asking us, you know, mimosas. What do you use for mimosas? I don't want to use a $25 bottle of champagne. I don't want to use this. I don't want to. Here's something where you don't have to sacrifice on quality. Good quality, nice fine tiny bubble, nice fruit up front, perfect by itself. Mix it with orange juice, make a Bellini, whatever you'd like.
Now you're looking at a $25 bottle from the Champagne region.
Correct.
And now you go down to a quote-unquote champagne, but it's not from the Champagne region.
Right, and that is around $9.99 a bottle, 10 bucks a bottle. You can't go wrong. Taste it, nice fruit up front. People that don't like champagne really found this to be very, very pleasing. Just fruity, easy to drink.
For 10 bucks, unbelievable.
Can't beat that.
Now we're moving to the next one. What do we have here, Jerry?
We have an Italian Prosecco. And what it is basically something really, really unique. It's the rage of the past year or so. Everybody loves Prosecco. You know, when we go visit our winemaker friends in Italy, you walk into any restaurant or you walk into their homes, the first thing they do is they greet you with a little taste. What this does is basically it's a palate opener. It gives you the sparkle and the bubble. It just says, number one, it says welcome. Number two, it just opens your palate. You're going to sit down and have a meal. I think it's been made famous by the famous Harry's Bar in Venice with the Bellini, when they mix it with white peach nectar. But I think it's fun by itself. Fruity, soft, a little bit of sweetness to it. And I'll tell you, it outsold champagne last year 5-1. It's a perfect wine. You can actually have this with like provolone. You can have this with salty like prosciutto or salami. Or you know, ideally with figs. With a little reduced balsamic vinegar, this makes it explode.
Fantastic. And our last one over here.
This is the Domaine Carneros Brut. This is owned by the famed Patanger family of France, but this is actually made in Carneros, in the Napa Valley. great thing about this is their winemaker, Eileen Crane, again, going back to another woman winemaker, is basically the sparkling wine queen. She really puts sparkling wine from California on the map. This is the chateau that this is made in. It's exactly like the one in France, using the typical champagne grapes, same blend, same style, aged pretty much the same way. Tremendous, tremendous value. At 20 bucks a bottle, under 25 bucks a bottle, this is, you'd be hard pressed to find something better.
I'm tasting a champagne from France, and I'm tasting a sparkling wine from California, made by one of the top champagne houses, Tatt & Jay.
Definitely.
And I like the sparkling from California better.
You'd be hard pressed. People get misled by labels. They say California, oh, it can't be good. It can't be good. Tasted this blind, you'll be hard pressed. It's all about the methodology going into producing the wine. You'd find that you can't go wrong.
Hey, Jerry, thanks so much. We got four great wines. And also, we have one here, which a Prosecco, which you haven't tried, you have to do. It's growing in popularity like crazy. I learned a lot about champagne. I learned a lot about sparkling wine, and we got a little taste of Prosecco. You know what, Jerry? Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
We're going to ask him some more questions. But you know what? If you want anything else to learn, go to stewswines.com, okay? And just ask us any question. We'll be happy to answer it. Have a great day. And enjoy your sparkling and champagnes.